Hey guys, and welcome back. Thank you so much for being here. If you guys are new, hey, what's up? My name is Mabel, and welcome to my channel. Today, I'm going to be doing a video on first impressions. I have a couple goodies here. I have the new Anastasia subculture palette that everybody has been going crazy over. I also have a new sleek palette that I've never tried before. I also have these new lashes that I got off AliExpress that I will be using. New liner, new lipsticks, like a whole bunch of stuff. So if you guys want to see this full face using mostly first impressions, then just keep on watching and don't forget to subscribe before you leave. Alright guys, so as you could see, my hair is wet, and that is because I washed my hair, obviously, before starting this video. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this out of our face, get all this hair out of our face. I was supposed to film this earlier, but I was going nuts trying to connect my computer to my Mac to use it as a viewfinder, and that was an epic fail, so I'm going to have to go to somebody that actually knows what the hell they're doing, because I have no idea. As always, we're gonna go ahead and start the brows. I don't have any new brow products today, so I'm just going with my usual Anastasia Brow Wiz. All right, now that our brows are on, we're gonna go in with my usual Too Faced RX primer, of course. What difference is there there? After that, I'm gonna go in with this Skin Fix little moisturizer, just to add a little more moisture to my face. And for a little more moisture, I'm gonna go in with my Mario spray. You guys know the drill, as usual, my Tarte Shape Tape to prime my eyes. All right guys, the moment of truth. We're gonna go in with the Subculture palette by Anastasia. Beautiful palette. I did swatch it, but the film's still in here and all that. It's beautiful. I love the color scheme. Just so scared. I'm scared, bitch. I'm scared. But you know what? We're gonna do something real simple. We're gonna do nothing crazy. And I heard just with one little tap, that's all you need. One tap. So you know what? That's exactly what we're gonna do. One tap. As a transition, I'm gonna go in with Edge to begin. So one tap, two taps. Okay, that was three taps. So let's go into the crease. This is one of the colors that people were having issues with. But you know what? Okay. Tapping in again, I tapped in twice. I'm gonna layer that. Wow, it looks brown almost. And it's a yellow color. Tapping in one more time. Am I supposed to do this? Okay, I'm gonna tap in three times, just lightly, and we're gonna go on the other eye. Yeah, I don't know if I like this brush. I'm gonna just switch brushes quick. I'm gonna go in with this Sigma blending brush, E35. Ooh. Okay, see, since this is more of a natural hair bristle, it like kicks up more product. So maybe that's a trick to not use a natural hair, a brush more like this. Use one that's synthetic. maybe more like this, so that it wouldn't kick back much. Because, you know, natural hair brushes are so, like, they could be so harsh, they could poke your eye and stuff. But, oh! Point fucking proven! Jesus! I'm dipping in one time. Wow. So a lot of kickback. Okay, so this eye looks more yellow than this one. I am seeing starting to see some oxidation here. But, you know, we'll make it work. It didn't blend like there. Or maybe that's my eye color. I don't know. Anyway, after we go in with Edge, we're gonna go into New Wave. We're gonna put this also in the crease to build up definition. After New Wave, I'm gonna take this little brush here, synthetic brush, and I'm going to fudge. Wow. I tapped in once. One time. Sigma blending brush. I'm gonna blend out that color. Diffuse it. What the hell, man? Tapping in one time. Again. I was rooting for this. What the hell? Come on. It's not working into my crease. It's just sitting there. It looks so, like, I don't know if you guys can see, but it's just stuck there. Like, do y'all see that? It's not diffusing into my crease. It's just staying there. I'm gonna go into New Wave and I'm gonna use this for the tops, for the top of my crease right up here, just to create some definition going back in. For the lid, I'm gonna go in with Adorn, which is supposed to be a metallic finish. This one right here, and then the brush just fell. This one right here. I'm gonna go in with that one for my lid just to see, because I love colors like this. So I'm gonna go in with this little Anastasia brush. The one, it didn't come with the palette, there's just a different one. And I'm gonna just swipe in there. This doesn't pick up much at all. Maybe I should have cut my crease. Let me see. Hold on. Let me try to cut my crease. My crease is cut. And let's see if that makes a difference. To be real, guys, like, to be so real. Oh, this palette requires a lot of blending, and some of the colors do stick. Like this fudge that I just placed out here, it won't blend out, and it makes it look like I don't know how to do makeup. This shit right here is overrated. Y'all see what this shit did? You know, I'm over this shit. I'm just gonna make it as symmetrical as I can, and I'm moving the fuck on, because that just pissed me the fuck off. I'm gonna go in with the Maybelline Curvitude eyeliner. For real though, guys, I like this liner. I really like this liner. Alright, so now that we're done with the eyes, as y'all saw, that was a disaster itself. We're gonna go ahead and move on to the face. For foundation today, I'm going to be using the L'Oreal Infallible Foundation. I am in the color 109 Classic Tan, as I am in almost all drugstore foundations. For concealer, I don't have anything new, so as always, I'm gonna go in with my Wet n Wild and my Tarte Shape Tape to conceal under my eyes and highlight in my high points. Powder, so I'm gonna just go in with my Cover Effects just to set all my highlighted areas. So the face, we're gonna go in with my L'Oreal True Match just to give love to every other place that I didn't. Item, it isn't new to me. I have another one of these, but this is the Anastasia Contour and Highlighting Kit, the contour kit in Deep Tan. My other one is from Light to Medium. They didn't have my color in stock when I went to buy it, so I ended up picking this one up just recently, and we're gonna use this one today. I don't know where it stopped, but my camera just shut off. But, oh my god, that just pissed me off. If I didn't show, I was using the Anastasia Deep to Tan Contour Kit. I have the Light to Medium in this one. I'm just using these two top colors to chisel out my cheeks. Now that we are contoured, I'm gonna go ahead with my Mario spray. Spray my face. And y'all already know I'm gonna do my favorite trick, which is taking my beauty blender and just lightly passing over all the powdered areas on my face. This takes away all the powderiness from all the products that we have used, and it melts it into your skin. I'm gonna go back into that contour kit, and I'm gonna go with my usual dome brush. And I'm just lightly tap this color here in the end, because I like how it looks. And I'm just going to softly chisel and with the same brush that we used, lightly go back and diffuse. Let's leave our face alone for a while. And let's go back into this disaster to finish the lower lash line. For my lower lash line, I'm going with this small little crease brush. And I'm going to go into New Wave for my lower lash line. After New Wave, I'm going to go in just tapping lightly once into Fudge. You guys see how much product that picks up with just one dip. And I'm going to go under as well. With Cube, which is the white but transfers into pink color in the Subculture palette, and I'm gonna place that in my inner corner. Wow, this is nice. I'm gonna go in with the Big Shot by Maybelline. Again, I don't really like this much, but I can't find my L'Oreal Telescopic and it's driving me insane. These Mink eyelashes that I got off AliExpress. I do not buy makeup off AliExpress. I just use AliExpress strictly to get my eyelashes, and these are one of them. These are so pretty, and they were like $5. I'm gonna go ahead and pop these on with my duo lash glue, and I'll be right back to complete the look. Guys, lashes are on. I like these because in the box they look dramatic, but they're not so dramatic, but they're still like boom in your face, you know what I mean? So the only thing that sucks about Ali is that their packaging doesn't have names on them, but this actually has like a legit name. I believe the name is like D-U-E or something like that. I don't know. But if I could find them, I'll see if I could link them down below, because I know that YouTube has like a strict policy on promoting fake makeup. But since this isn't fake makeup, it's just eyelashes, I don't see why I wouldn't be able to link them. But I'm gonna just see if I could do it. If I find them, I'll link them down below. Put some mascara on my actual lashes, not on the fake ones, just so they could blend in. Because one trick, like one thing that I can tell you guys is, you don't ever want to put mascara on your fake Mink lashes. You just don't want to do that. We're gonna go in with some blush. I'm not really a blush person. If you look back at my videos, you would see that I hardly or ever wear blush, but everybody talks about this damn blush, and I saw it and I picked it up because it's always sold out. It is the Milani Luminoso blush. I'm gonna go ahead and apply that. Apply that using a little Wet n Wild stippling brush. So next we're gonna go in with the Sleep palette, Cleopatra's Kiss one, not the Solstice. I have the Solstice. It's actually one of my favorite highlighting palettes, so that's why I decided to go out and get the Cleopatra's Kiss, because I've heard so many good things about this one too. Wow, it's really pretty. It fits more my skin tone. It suits more my skin tone, but it's more like this. It looks like this. This top color up here on my Makeup Shack highlighting brush. Now that we are all highlighted to the gods, let's go on to the lips. So for the lips, I'm gonna use this NYX Suede lip liner in the color London. Color, I'm going to go in with the new Anastasia Matte Lift lipsticks in the color Honey right on top. I love the feel of this. It feels like a velvet component. And this is what the actual lipstick looks like. So cute. It's black and sleek, and it has the rose gold detailing in the bottom. And this is what the lipstick looks like. It is a beautiful nude color. Really up my alley, like I love it. And honestly, if you like, you can keep it like this, but I'm a gloss girl. So for gloss, I'm gonna go in with this new Ulta Lip Plumping Top Coat. It's in Ethereal, and it has these beautiful, beautiful reflex of like gold. Alright guys, give me 1 second. I'm gonna be right back. I'm gonna just go on and do my hair. Alright guys, and this is the completed look. I hope you guys enjoyed. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe for more videos. Thank you so much for being here, and until next time.